Agne, there is a lot of information about diet and MS out there, but I believe none have yet been proven to alter the course of MS. Knowing this, can you talk about how what we can eat can have a positive effect on MS symptoms?
Diet is a very hot topic. It's very important to think that healthy lifestyle and healthy living is not just diet. It's a complementary tool. So it's important to think about the products and think about that all the ultra-processed and processed foods are really harmful because they have a lot of sugar in it, a lot of salt in it, a lot of other chemicals that are definitively upsetting our microbiome, which is our normal healthy gut flora, and influencing the way our immune system functions. We're not promoting any types of diet because there is no evidence that any particular diet has got a positive effect on the brain health. If you have a variety of colors on your plate, that's the way forward.
That's great advice. So, minimizing or eliminating processed foods as much as possible, eating fresh, healthy, natural produce, and preparing food at home. You mentioned about trial and error of seeing what diets work for you. What does that look like? What would your advice be to someone who's trying to figure out what the best nutrition plan is for them?
We need to more often listen to our bodies. You know, we quite often are very busy with our lives and we ignore our body needs and how we feel. If you have a huge amount of sugar, a rush of sugar, your whole body just buzzes. You know, you have some sort of a buzzing sensation in your body and it's a short resolution, but then thereafter you have a knock-on effect and you feel some indigestion, some stomach aches, some maybe more tingling and buzzing sensation in your body. So really listen to your body and find out what exactly you had. Perhaps keep the diary and start documenting, you know, plan your meal time. You know, you may say, well, the healthy diet might be very expensive, which is not. You know, the expensive part is your time. Time to plan your meals every week. And perhaps you can spend, you know, Saturday or Sunday writing, documenting products that you're going to buy. And if you look at the prices, you know, processed food versus organic food that is fresh, you buy that on the farms, for example. So it's much, much cheaper economically if you do some calculations. So I think the argument that is much, much expensive is a very weak argument.
Those are great tips. I know my husband and I have been getting a weekly organic produce box for probably 15 years, and the price has not gone up. It can be, in a way, more affordable, and also it helps for me to force me to sort of eat what's in season. Can you talk about the role of supplements in MS?
A lot of people coming to see me, they are on a lot of supplements. Some of them tried so many different vitamins. And I think it's a lot of marketing around the supplements. So whether we have a strong evidence in multiple sclerosis, we actually haven't got apart from vitamin D. So anybody who are diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, they should be on vitamin D3. And the dose is variable, but we do not recommend to exceed 5,000 international units daily. Why we recommend vitamin D? We know that from some emerging research, that it can affect the immune cells and it reduces some inflammation and it can slow down the progression of the MS. There are some studies to suggest that vitamin D can enhance the certain first-line disease-modifying therapy efficacy. But you can experiment a number of other agents that works for you. Again, be mindful, explore, investigate, and see how it works. I think it's not going to harm you. It's probably going to make your urine more expensive. And it has got a lot of antioxidants in it. And it's just the way how you feel. And if you have a great belief that is helping you, it's not going to harm. Go ahead and use them.
There is no evidence that any specific diet helps MS. However, a balanced, healthy diet can promote gut fauna and improve the immune system. When choosing food, it's important to pay attention to the way you feel and what your body needs. Vitamin D3 is proven to have positive effects on MS, and it's recommended to take no more than 5,000 international units daily.
I hope you found that video useful. You can find more MS content on our channel or click the link to watch the next MS video.